Yeah, Whip's quite good. I give her a B.
Okay. I can do B.
Let's see.
That's Shangua.
Thank you.
She had the sword. She did all the things like I'm a fighter for justice. Just kidding.
Yeah, no, I know her. It was a case of I wasn't sure how to pronounce her name was where my hesitance
was. I think the game was pronounced as like Shangua.
I'm indifferent to her, to be honest.
I always kind of had a soft spot for her, although she was never a favorite. She was good. She had some good high-low mix-ups and stuff.
Let's see. What do you want to give her?
I mean, she's kind of a... I think she's kind of a B.
All right.
Like, I liked her more than some than several of the people we have in C, but not enough to put her... Nowhere near enough to put her in A.
Let's see. Yuri Sakazaki. I love Shuri's. I love Yuri.
It's one of those things where I think if I played more KOF, I'd like her more. But with how much of KOF or how little I've played, I feel like I like her energy, but I don't know her enough to like her more than just that.
She's kind of similar to Sakura in the fact that she predates Sakura, in the fact that she's kind of like started out as like being like using goofier versions of Ryo and Robert's moves, but kind of just became her own. She's got one of my favorite like throws in King of Fighters where she just grabs the person and just slaps the hell out of them. It makes like a sound like she's hitting like something made of tin repeatedly.
Yeah, I've seen it. She's kind of like, yeah.
And depending on the game, she has this in 98. She doesn't have it in all the games, though. Is she has this one super where she just runs up and just stomps the hell out of the character. It's freaking great. Like, she stomps them to where she, like, kind of climbs up them and then, like, jumps off of them. It's amazing.
All right. Well, I'm willing to refer to you on Yuri, then.
I would give Yuri an A, honestly.
Okay. Let's do it.
All right.
I'm not sure who this is. She has kind of Tekken energy about her, though.
Yeah, she also looks like she's just put her hand at us, like, whatever.
Like, talk to the hand. I don't have time for you.
Alright,
I'm gonna scroll through the Tekken list again. See if I can find her on it.
I do know the last two characters. Oh, hey, they are missing a Skullgirl character, but I guess that's understandable.
They're missing everyone from Samurai Showdown.
Well, they're missing, what's her name? Is it Double? Is that her name? The shapeshifter.
I don't. Yeah, Double. But Double doesn't really have a gender. I don't know. It'd be kind of like saying Beowulf isn't on here. Well, he's in Skullgirls.
Yeah, I know. That's why I was kind of like, eh. It's like she's not there, but I kind of can understand why. But still, just notice that.
I feel like there's also we're missing other people. I'm just drawing a blank right now.
Anyways, we need
this is far from a complete list, but yeah, I'm getting distracted.
Who is this lady that's giving us the hand and we just don't understand?
That might be Zafina from Tekken. Let me see if I can find a different photo of her.
I don't remember her. I do like how they randomly threw a freaking Virtue Fighter character in here just to F with us.
Yeah, that's Zafina.
I don't remember her.
It looks like... Yeah, that looks like her. Yeah, that's just one of her outfits. One of her alternate outfits than the one that's on the wiki.
Ah. Got an opinion on her? Because I don't.
No, I didn't even know who she was.
I guess she doesn't know.
Yeah.
I do know Zaronda.
Yep.
Isn't she Brazilian? I mean, she looks.
I believe so. Yeah, she's currently definitely hangs out with the other Brazilians, doesn't she?
Yeah, she's Brazilian. She has cool moves. She's attractive, and she has a toucan.
Yeah. What's not to love?
Yeah, toucan is a plus for me. Follow your nose. He's gonna get you some food.
I'll follow your nose. Oh, he found ass.
I'd give Zaronda either low A or high B.
I'm willing to do B.
Alright.
I like her, but I haven't played her, so I can't really. And there she is.
Valentine.
I do like the move she does where like she pulls up the curtain. Hello.
All right, you're back.
Yeah, that was weird. So my internet went out briefly, and then when it came back, Discord just wouldn't reconnect to the internet, even though everything else did.
Sounds about right.
Yeah, but
anyways, you were saying about Valentine.
What was the last thing you heard?
You were talking about one of her moves, and then you died.
Oh, no, I was just saying that I was just making some wisecrack about how sexy Valentine, sexy nurse is overdone, but sexy murder nurse is somewhat less overdone, unless you count Silent Hill 2, and otherwise she was never one that really appealed to me, so, but you seem to have more thoughts on her than I do.
I'm also not a huge fan. I think her super where she, like, does surgery on you is kind of cool.
Yeah.
I like the fact that she's not just a murder nurse, she's a ninja nurse, which I think is...
That's right.
Which is kind of a... Which is funny in the fact that it's kind of like squishing two, like, big anime tropes together.
I forgot about the ninja side.
Other than that, I don't really care much for her. I know she's got a lot of fans for reasons.
See?
And I'm sure that, thermometer wind pose doesn't help on that. yeah, I'm not a huge fan, to be honest. She's not... Yeah, she's probably one of the lesser characters for me, honestly. I think I use her more than Pain Will, but...
Yeah, like, she's very much one of those, like, I don't dislike her, but she's just kind of whatever, so I would probably put her in C, personally.
I will agree with that.
Alright.
And with that, we have completed this.
We didn't quite get it as balanced as we usually do. We ended up with a couple more B's than C's, but otherwise, I think we did a pretty good job.
I think so too. Let's see.
Oh no, there was one more thing I wanted to bring up with you.
Oh.
So we were generally doing, I think, one game character per series generally did it for us. But considering how many characters we liked in KOF, we didn't have a single KOF character hit S tier for us.
No, we didn't.
Do you think there's a KOF character that could make that jump?
Yes, Athena.
That we could agree could make that jump?
How about Shermie?
Shermie's strong. What about King, though?
I like King a lot, but I don't like her as S tier as much as I'm sure James would like her as S tier.
And I like Shermie a lot, but I haven't really had too many chances to play her, so I don't know if she really has that little extra something for me to go that high.
Because, see, if I got the pick, I'd pick either Athena or Yuri, because they're my favorites, but... What about Leona?
I like Leona a lot. For me, she might be S tier, but oh gosh, she's a charge character, though.
That's true.
If she weren't a charge character, I think I might put her up there. So I think it's one of those things where perhaps individually we might have people who could put an S, but I don't think we can necessarily have we both agree on a character who would go up to S.
What about BGNA or Kula?
Ooh, I do like Kula, but I don't know if I like Kula enough to put her in S, though. I do like her a lot, though. She's a big cutie.
Got it.
Vanessa's also really cool.
Vanessa is really... You know what? I'd be willing to put Vanessa in S.
You really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
Let's fucking do it.
Vanessa's S.
Big mom power.
Big mom power. I've got to re-download the thing now.
Vanessa is really fucking cool, though.
She is. Got some big mom power. Will punch you in the face if you talk bad about her kids.
That's kind of the thing about KOF. KOF's got a lot of characters that aren't necessarily, like, larger than life, But they're just, like, the way they all interact with each other is still just makes them interesting.
I just realized there's another series we don't have an A-tier on.
Who's that?
We don't have an A-tier Street Fighter character. Oh, no, we do. It's Minette. Never mind. Sorry.
Yeah, I put Minette up there and you didn't fight me on it.
Yeah. No, so, yeah, we did. We got...
Yeah. I'm trying to think.
We don't have an A-tier for Tekken, but
We don't?
I mean, S-tier for Tekken. We don't have an S-tier
okay.
for Tekken.
Because, I mean, honestly, Tekken, I haven't played enough to be able to put anyone up there. I mean, I have a couple of characters that Tekken I like a lot, but I don't know if I like them enough to put him in S.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. I mean, Asuka's probably the closest, and even she's really not... I wouldn't give her S tier. But yeah, we got Guilty Gear, we got Dead or Alive, Darkstalker, Street Fighter... Skullgirls, BlazBlue, and King of Fighters up there.
I will say, I think this list wouldn't be too different if we were doing it individually, but I think it's interesting to see the characters who wound up in S that we had to agree on rather than the ones you'd individually put up there. Like, you would have put Athena and Chun-Li up there, probably.
Yeah.
But you wouldn't... Vanessa might not have wound up there... Might not have wound up there without us working together, and Minot would not have been up there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, because Chun-Li would have been up there.
Yeah.
I do love the fact that we both instantly agreed on Baiken and Ayane as S. That was just like...
I mean, it's... I mean, just what? Of course!
It was just... Especially Baiken. Baiken was just instant, both of us. Just S.
And I think the only other time I had such a strong reaction was when we got to Platinum, and I was just like, F! F!
The only one in F, I might add.
I really don't like... Actually, you know what I realized? Another series that wasn't on here? We did not get Undernight.
Oh, yeah. I'm not very familiar with that one. I've played it, but I'm not very familiar with it.
I like Undernight, and I think I have a character I would have put an S. I do like... Did I just forget her name? Fuck, I think I did just forget her name. No! I'm so ashamed. I was about to say, yeah, I would totally put her in S and I forgot her name. I always forget her name, though. It's Hyde's sister.
If they wanted to go more OG, we could have had Bloody Roar.
Yeah, we could have had Bloody Roar. That's a good point.
Let's see, favorite character in that, I don't remember her name, and she turned into like a cat and she had big sleeves.
Are you talking about Yuriko the Half Beast?
Yes.
She was fun. I liked Yuriko.
She was my favorite.
She probably was mine too. Just because she was just running like wild. Everyone else would be like, I'm gonna play this character and do this now. I'm like, okay, fine, I'm just gonna like run circles around you until you don't know where I am, it's fine.
Unfortunately,
and she also meows.
Yes, which is great. Unfortunately, we probably won't get another one of those games anytime soon.
Probably not.
Because that was a Hudson property, and well, we know who has those licenses.
Yes. Sadly, many fighting game series, some of which actually probably could make comebacks, may not make comebacks ever.
There's no Killer Instinct in here.
Yuzuriha. I remember her name. She's also got a kicking theme.
Let's see. Like I said, there's no Killer Instinct in here, which that did make a comeback. And it's supposed
to be. There really wouldn't have been many characters to go on this list, though, because that would have been like just Orchid.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's kind of it. Oh, no. What about that one? The one little girl was like the caveman girl?
Oh, yeah. She's kind of cool.
I forget her name, though.
And. Of course, MK isn't here.
Of course.
Which I'm okay with, but...
Look, what do you got against Melina?
I have nothing against Melina. Or Shiva.
Or Katana.
I just don't like Mortal Kombat that much. I need to play one of the new ones, though, because to be quite honest, all I've played is the old Mortal Kombat games, and I didn't really care for them. When they came out, I always thought they were really stiff.
Yeah, the new ones seem pretty cool, but I'm gonna be honest. This is kind of weird to say, given how long I've been playing video games and how much I've been exposed to. Okay, there we go. Let's see if it sticks this time.
Now, probably shouldn't stay on too much longer because I do have work tomorrow. But you were saying about Mortal Kombat?
Yeah, just MK11, the most recent one, has actually reached a level of realism and visceralness to the gore that it's actually made me sick to my stomach. And considering how much gore I've seen in video games through the years, that's impressive and honestly kind of disturbing.
Yeah, I've seen some of the fatalities on that, and even I'm kind of like, ugh. And I used to watch slasher movies and stuff, and somewhere I'm even like, eck.
Yeah, from what I understand, they're actually apparently so visceral that some of the devs actually have like PTSD from working on the visuals.
That would not surprise me. Because I think I saw one recently where it had the character like, literally like, via telekinesis pull out the freaking intestinal tract of someone from their mouth, and I was just like, oh god, why is that necessary?
Yeah, I think the most recent one I saw, which is it was interjected into another video I was watching, was like, I think it was Kunlan like just cut someone in half down the middle, and you know, that's, you've seen that any number of times, but it's actually like meaty and visceral, and you can like see individual like bones and organs and guts just spilling and squirming. Ugh.
Nothing.
No, that's, I mean, I hear the game is actually pretty solid though, it's just I wouldn't want to deal with that.
Yeah, not my thing.
Same.
Anyways, this is the tier list, this is the final results, and I'm happy with this, how this came out. Like,
yeah.
Like you mentioned, there are some things that would change if we were individual, like Chun-Li would be in top, and so would Athena, but...
Well, for your list at least, not for mine.
Yeah. But, no, this is good. I am...
Yeah.
Oh, wait. There is another character. We don't have a Soul Calibur character in S tier.
We don't?
Oh.
You're right, we don't.
Eh, that's fine. I don't think we have one in... I don't think any of the Soul Calibur characters made A tier either. I think the highest...
Really?
Yeah, I think the highest any of them got was B tier.
That surprises me a little bit. I think it's because we couldn't agree on Cassandra Safidi, I think. Otherwise, they probably would have, one of them would have wound up on A tier for each of us.
Probably. Though, if I was to pick a Soul Calibur character that I would put in S, or maybe even A, it would have been Taki. But, like I said, I adore Taki. But, I am happy with this list. I still can't believe Sarah Bryant randomly got thrown in here on us. Confused the hell out of us.
Yeah, like, surprise, it's Sarah, but no one else from Virtua Fighter? Yeah, okay.
It's like she was literally just put there to mess with us. Because we're like, is this Nina again?
And then I was like, man, could this be Samus? Because alphabetically, S.A. would go after whoever was before her in the list. And she does kind of look like a Samus, but no, it's Sarah.
Samus isn't sleepless.
Balls.
But enjoyed this doing this tier list a lot, and would definitely like to do more of these in the future.
These are fun.
See.
Although it definitely took a lot longer, I think either of us were expecting.
Yeah, because I honestly need to get to sleep soon. So.
All right, then you get yourself to sleep, and I get myself probably also to sleep, honestly.
All right. I'll talk to you. Thanks for joining us, and I'll talk to you guys later.
Bye.